Good morning. So hopefully today, finishing up testing of Snippet Pixie next database migrations before we start on the daemon and the CLI. So let's see where we were. So at the moment, on the database stuff, got test for happy path, no database, closed database, and the schema already up to date. Excuse me. So what we need to do tests for now are the different versions. So we need to handle the case where we have version Snippet Pixie version 1.0 database, 1.5, and we've already handled 1.6 because that's the current schema version. So what I think I'll do is I will just take that don't think I need anything else. And then I'm going to, well, before we do anything, let's do a quick run of the tests. Sure everything's fine at the moment. Yep. So what we'll do we'll take that the very basic first version of Snippet Pixie. Just had a snippets table. That's all we needed. With an integer primary key. Let's just do Maybe I should just do these. As versioned tests. And then in the future, if I need to do any changes, I just need to add new versions. So of course 160 for the moment. I think that needs a little extra work, an original test there. I think what would be nice would be if I do. I need to do kind of some of this. But not quite. What I'm thinking is I'll probably for this little test. I should ensure that there's already data in there because we're not testing that at the moment. Let's do that. Let's do very quick. need to kind of want to do a scale, but versioned. A little bit far. I think so. I think I'll just do some basic stuff on the init schema. I need to go grab data for that. I need one of them. That's bad. So we're generating a new UID. Last used here is just 0. Instead, just do it now. Okay. And I'll just create a few of these. Schema here, same thing, but don't want to specify the ID. I'll let it create its own. We don't have a last used. This is the one I'm most interested in, apart from the 150 test as well. I want to make sure that we get data actually migrated. So why that's complaining. Yeah, but things have changed since then, so. I think. That does create a, also incrementing. That's the existing one. It does work as is, so primary key must do the job. Okay, so we have init schema 100. Change that description as well. So at the moment, all we've actually changed for testable code is this stuff here. There's no tests of that data, but we have added it. In a minute, we'll test it here. But for the time being, just a quick check that that's not broken anything. Interesting. Unique constraint failed. Oh. Yes. Because I was only generating the ID once. Going to keep that same. I'm going to create new IDs each time. Let's give it a quick test. could just do... Basically that. It's going to be our test going forward. So, on this schema test, creating the schema nice and early with existing data. We then bring up the manager. It, in theory, will make no changes to the schema. And so we should be able to just grab the data that exists already. And we're going to do a test of grabbing anything ending with P backtick. Shouldn't be any errors. There should be two of them. And the first one should be BP because they've all got the same last use date. We'll see. Cool. Okay. Well, that's a good start then. So let's do same test ish. But for schema 100. So going back in time. So we're in its schema 100. And then we do exactly the same test. Should, in theory, be the same. Result should work. I might add a little check for UUIDs and things in a minute. But... Ooh, nope. Never iterating over existing snippets. Scanner and come to name last use, unsupported scan, storage library, blah blah blah. Interesting, why is that? Oh. Good. Okay, well, that's a good catch. I think that means that the migration from no last used column to having it didn't set the default value. Huh. Okay. So when you add a snippet, it defaults that. So in the migration, so this, so the last one where we just do UUID should be fine. We should already have last used as to the timestamps. But this migration here, where we need to add it. So what does it look like? It's just a timestamp. Starters, that should be uppercase, as is the norm. I think all we need to do is just set it as 0. Really, what I should be doing is using a default of 0. Okay, I'm going to do two little things here then. I am going to update it straight after the initial migration. Doesn't complain. Oh, still complains. Yes, I know. That's the point. Yes, I know. How do I tell I don't care? Right, there you go. That's quite handy, that actually. Should really do one of those funky defer close. But I don't really care about that. Huh. That's handy, but I'm doing that just now. Wait, I'll come back to that. Let's do right, so in theory, that fixes the bug. No such table UID snippets. The migration is failing now. Why? Okay, so what'd you do that for? Okay. Turn that out again. Schema setup. Create the table Can I run just a single test? Go. Go help test. Interesting. But I can run that. Runs there. Goes through a different tool. Okay. Right. Okay. Well, it's doing the wibble. So. But it doesn't get here though. No. Okay. Let's try. So in theory, it's 9 here. Oh, no, of course it's not. It's just a query. So it should get here and then die. But yeah, and we're only getting one, so that will not work this time. Yeah, so why is it failing? Not let me know. Because that which doesn't make any sense. Given that we're doing other data updates there. Missing. Can I do that? Nope. Can I see what this does. Okay, cool. So in theory then, database is open. Go in here. We've got rows, we've got no error. Defer the close. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Not putting anything. It has now. Okay. Creating an ID. Now we have an error. How can that be? We just created it beforehand. So I think I might have a fundamental issue here. Something weird is going on. I wonder. Out of time. Nothing going on there. So we now have a snippet. Definitely has a UID. Ten, 1, 3, 3, 2, 2, 4. Get a result. Different same data. 10, 1, 3, 3, 2, 2, 4. So it's the migration that's failing for sure when you've got data. I've got to stop. Yep, gonna have to look into that. I don't know why. Just doing that one update, which doesn't fail. Does something with a database. To screw things up. Or more to the point, because we have data, because that's what we're at now, for the first time. Yeah, what is it about having data that's causing this to fail? To do. Why is having data causing Failure due to UI D snippets not existing. Okay. A mystery for another day. So, until next time, thanks for watching and you take care.